Thank you for inviting me. Thank you for just taking a moment to listen to me. I appreciate that very, very much. I am proud to be the co-chair of our caucus along with Chris Van Hollen. And I just want to thank all of you for the work that you do. You know, Washington State, where I'm from, is very engaged in renewables, and we're working hard with the folks within our state across the country to move renewables ahead. I get excited about the technology around renewables, and I know that in this room, you're looking at some of that, you all are engaged in that, you see it happening across the world. I think our young people are getting excited about the technology in renewables. How many have been in a Tesla? How many have driven a Tesla? How many own a Tesla? Yeah, well, I've been in one. That's just part of the excitement. So you think about what we can do with the energy that operates your car, right? And that thing can move pretty doggone fast. We didn't go over the speed limit because he knew he had an entire stop in his car. So yeah, we did experiment a little bit, however. So that's just an example of some of the technology ahead: wind energy, solar energy, thermal energy, all of those things that we can tap into that keep our state, like we like to say, Washington State, green, clean, and pristine, because we are. I want to share with you a real quick story, and you'll like this because it's kind of a police, it is a cop story. I was the lead detective in the Green River serial murder case. How many are familiar with that case? This, not many. Some. This person killed somewhere between 70 to 80 people in Washington State and Oregon. He pled guilty to 49 murders. You know what? You know how we caught this person? We caught this person through science. And it was the science of DNA. So this is why I get excited. In 1982, I was 31 years old. I had brown hair, and I'm investigating a serial murder. Right? I'm only 35, and I don't have brown hair. But I was investigating a serial murder. We collected evidence on the banks of a river south of Seattle. It was liquid evidence. It was fluid evidence from bodies. We froze it. In 1987, we collected a saliva sample from a suspect out of 40,000 tip sheets. 82, sample of evidence. 87, sample of evidence. Frozen. In 1999, DNA came along. There's not enough, though. Science had not been developed enough, but we still had faith that it would be. And we worked toward 2001 came, and in March of 2001, we submitted our evidence again. They said the science had come closer, and we were ready. We could take those minute samples, and we could examine those, and we think we could find your killer. On September 10th, the day before 9/11, my detectives and scientists came to my office and they said, we have identified your suspect from DNA. Out of 40,000 sheets, from evidence from 82 and 87, they identified one guy responsible for 49 murders. Now that's why I continue to have hope. Now how does this tie into renewable energy? It's the science, it's the research, it's the technology, it's the excitement about that all of us should have in this room about the future of all the technologies that you're looking at today that will move us forward to renewable, clean energy that will get us off of fossil fuels, it will free us from the rest of the world's fossil fuel energies, and make us an independent, clean, pristine, and green country, not just Washington State. So I appreciate your attention. Thank you for all the work you do. Continue to do that. Thank you and have a great day.